grumbling or something.
I think it was your pan there.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No.
All right.
Well, it could have been. I don't know.
North Law comes in with a record of 21 wins and 5 losses. Corbin with the record of 17 wins and 7 losses. Now, this is according to the, what do you call it, RPI? And they have North Laurel, this is number one, and Corbin is number two in the region. Then comes Knox Central, Harlan County, Belk County, South Laurel, Pineville, Jackson County, Whitley County, Clay County, Harlan, Waynesburg, Barberville, Lincoln, Middlesbrough, and Anita Baptist Institute. So, Corbin, this both teams are in the same region, but they're not in the same district. So sometimes it makes it a more fun game, just to kind of see where you size up. Corbin played them earlier this year in the WYMT Classic. That was only like the second or third game of the year for both teams, and Corbin won that game by a slim basket. So this should be a fun one.
It's going to be a good one, I feel.
A lot of baskets. North Laurel, the highest scoring team in the region. Corbin, as I look down here, you know Belk County scores more than we do, and South Laurel does too. So we depend a lot on defenses of shutting teams down.
Right. I was going to say, I think it depends a lot on our defense and how we're playing.
And of course, we put plenty of points on the board.
Oh, yes. Yes.
So without Bailey tonight.
I hate to hear that.
I was talking to her. She went down during the last game and just wasn't quite sure what it was about. And I think she said either they ran a test or they will run a test. But right now it looks like she may not be back until the district tournament.
Oh, wow.
Which the district tournament is hard to believe. It's only less than 2 weeks away. Next week, Tuesday, is the last home game. And we play tomorrow here against Clay County.
Right.
Tuesday against, I think it's Madison Central, who is the number one team in the 11th region.
Wow.
Boy, we got a loaded schedule. And then we're on the road against Knox Central, who is, according to this, the number three team in the region. So Coach Wilson does not... To make his team better, he chose one of the toughest schedules
I've ever seen. That's how you make them better. You play better.
Tonight, the Corbin Redhounds, the boys, they're over at Jackson County. They're playing Jackson County tonight. So that game is on the FM. We are on the AM tonight and also 105.3 FM. So you can also go to T1073.com and also sign up to watch this game. So that's one way you can do it, and especially if you got relatives out of the area. They would like to watch, see how these kids are doing.
Yes.
They can do it, you know, from anywhere in the world. Isn't that something?
That's
anywhere
awesome.
In the world you're going to be watching this thing. North is out on the floor. They are in their gold, their green and blue. I guess that's kind of like Notre Dame, the green and blue of
it
Notre Dame.
Yeah, that's kind of what that looks like.
Corbin still has not come out of the locker room after they warmed
they're
up early.
They're still conversing.
Conversing.
Yeah.
Two and a half minutes are on the clock, so get ready for all the pregame festivities. You know, the bands. I saw the band over there earlier. I thought they were going to be in here.
Yeah, they are. Is it JROTC?
Yeah.
They're going to be
presenting the colors because they had brought the list of names to the PA announcer before I came up here. As Corbin comes on the floor in their white home uniforms, piping and trimmed in red. Red ball print on the trunks. Tonight, Mahela Jordan will be starting in place of Bailey Stewart. North Laurel will look like this. Jalen Black, a junior, number 00. Chloe McKnight, a junior, number 54. Number 21, Brooke Nicholson, a sophomore. Number 5, Bella Sizemore. She's a sophomore. And her sister, number 23, Emily Sizemore, is a senior. So, and I checked with official score to make sure I got that right before I started saying that people were seniors and were brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
both teams. So we got a pretty good crowd since the boys are on the road and the girls are here. That's still not a bad crowd.
That's not a bad crowd.
When you split your folks up.
Yeah.
So right now, we're going to send it back to the station for a three-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll be ready for the start of this ballgame. 3 minute timeout. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhounds on WCTT.
Our world has dramatically changed over the past couple of years. We've all had to adjust to these changing times. But one thing that has not changed is the fact that the Hart family and Tri-County Cycle Sales is still serving southeastern Kentucky with the same quality products and service after the sale since 1968. Honda, Yamaha, Kawasaki, and Polaris are the biggest names in off-road adventure and can still be found at Tri-County Cycle Sales. For your next ATV or side-by-side, stop by the place where time has stood still. Tri-County Cycle Sales, located between Corbin and London on US 25 across from Kentucky Outdoorsman.
I hate box springs. Well, here at Sammy's Furniture, we hate them so much, when you buy any mattress $7.99 and up, we're going to give you one for free. So if you're thinking, yeah, Sammy's right, if box springs were a person, I would punch them in the face. Well, guess what? You can take the price of that box spring and deduct it from any adjustable base we've got in the store, and we've got over 16 of them. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture and Mattress, folks. We're open 7 days a week from 10 to 6, Sundays from 12 to 5. We've got 12 months same as cash financing if you need it. When you pick it up, you get an extra discount on top of a free box spring that we can't wait to get out of here. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture.
Dear past, present, and future football watchers, you know why we're here. The football season is back! Woo! And since that's too amazing to miss a single second's worth, Pepsi is officially giving you permission to always put football first. Like, maybe those in-laws are back in town. Well, better hope they're football fans, because your Sunday is completely booked. Long story short, crack open a Pepsi and don't let anything get between you and your football watching. With love, Pepsi. Made for football watching. That's what I like.
Have you been in a car accident? Whiplash is a common injury and very painful, leading to years of health problems. Discover a chiropractor that uses digital x-rays and will not twist your neck. Call and make your appointment with me, Dr. Deidre Pennington, and experience the difference at Pennington Wellness Chiropractic and Massage. Phone 606-261-2053.
If you're having problems, trust our Grammy.
We do!
Hometown Bank is proud of their name because Hometown Bank is proud of the hometowns they're in. In fact, their name is their mission, which is to take care of the communities in which they work and live. Hometown Bank is always here to help. So if you're buying a house, remodeling your kitchen, or need a home equity loan to combine other debt, come see Hometown Bank and find out how easy working with a Hometown Bank can be. Visit the Hometown Bank nearest you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Appalachian Wireless has a plan to make your life simpler. It's called Forward Pay. No contract, no credit check, no problem. Plans start at $19.99 a month and includes unlimited talk and text. Add 3 gigabytes of data, $29.99 per month. 6 gigabytes, $39.99 per month. Or take it to the max with unlimited data plus. Just $89.99 per month with 50 gigabytes of high-speed data. All the features of postpaid service without the long-term commitment. It's Forward Pay because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Unlimited data plus, lowest to 1 megabyte per second. Past 50 gigabytes is used.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Take it.
Welcome back to LU Gillen Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Klaus along with Angel Helton, where the color guard is now leaving the floor. We've just had the playing of the national anthem and the pregame prayer. Both teams getting ready to be introduced. Everyone's still standing, of course. If you've never been to a Corbin High School game, you remain standing until the colors have left the floor.
Absolutely.
Great respect for the flag.
Yes.
Thank you.
Now for the introduction of North Laurel.
A junior, 7-0, Kelly Black.
7-0, Jeremy Black.
Sophomore, number 21,
number 5. 5, Bella Sizemore. Number 21, Brooke Nicholson, a sophomore. And that would be Chloe McKnight. Now, Chloe McKnight's only a junior. She's a tall girl in that.
She is a big girl.
Lady Redhounds being introduced, Mahela Jordan, a junior. Number 2, Darcy Anderson, a junior. Right, Kylie Clem, a sophomore. Number 4, Callie Housley, number 11, a junior. And number 14, Reagan Walker, a sophomore. Corbin Redhounds come with a record of 17 wins and 7 losses. And as we said, North Wall comes out. Record of 21 wins and 5 losses. Kind of give you an idea. In the district, well, in the region, South Laurel is 10-1. In the region, Corbin is 10-0. So,
wow. You mean North Laurel?
North Laurel. I called them South, didn't I? North Laurel. Coach Wilson having a final few minutes, statements to tell his team as they're getting ready. North will be coming toward us. Corbin will be going toward, when I was in school, they called it the Commons area. Fancy name for the lunchroom.
For the lunchroom.
when they told us we had to go to the Commons area, we all went, where?
To the where?
Where? You know, where they eat lunch. Oh, the lunchroom. Jump is underway. Very good, good toss, but North Lowell controls the tip. Sizemore with it. She goes inside. Wow.
Wow. Quickly.
Chloe McKnight.
She went strong.
Back the other way. Hounds. Reagan Walker for a 3. Got it.
Nice.
3-2. Corbin on top. 7:36 to go here in the first quarter, in case you just joined us. Corbin opens up man-to-man. Ball tipped away by Walker. Picked up by Darcy. Anderson has it, goes to her left. Emily for a 3, a little short, you could tell, short. Follows your shot, but North Laurel comes out of there with it. Quickly on the move. Down the lane, all the way, no good. Rebound, Callie Housley runs into Reagan, but comes away with it. Gives it off to Emily Clem. Clem?
Kylie.
Kylie Clem, what? Is it Friday gonna be one of them days?
That's all right, Gus. You'll get it. You'll get it.
That's why you're here.
Yeah, I'm your backup.
Keep me in line. Darcy thought about shooting that 3. Gives it to Housley. Kylie goes in the corner. Kylie gets it back. Starts the drive. Gets cut off to Kylie. Gives it to Reagan Walker. Reagan to Housley. Housley in the lane. Oops, no good. She's knocked down, but no call. North comes out of there quickly with the ball. In the corner, long 3, no good. Rebound back up,
oh, wow.
Short, missed. Back up and in. Once again by McKnight. Well, North, we can't allow North to get three mm-hmm. shots at the basket from point blank range. North back on top, 4-3. Darcy Anderson at the free throw line. Shot no good, but nice rebound by Jordan. Gives it to Darcy, shot way too high. Coming up over the rim.
Need to settle their nerves down.
This is just for bragging rights. This isn't not in your district or anything. Down the lane, they kick it back out. Long 3, no good. Rebound. I was going to say it's out on Reagan Walker.
No, I disagree.
I think they tipped out of her hands.
She tipped it out, yeah.
Britt Nicholson took that shot, and Chloe McKnight, I thought, knocked it out of her hands. Comes out. Play no good. Ooh, rebound Nicholson. She just jumped higher than everybody else. Gives it off. Sizemore has it. Looks for inside. Almost tipped away. Reagan Walker has it. She's going to drive. Oh, she almost lost it. Now it's going to be a jump ball. Whenever Chloe McKnight's not looking, we try to go around her and tip it away from her.
Yes.
4-3, North Laurel on the lead. Anderson fakes the shot, now drives the lane, about a 5-foot floater. Oh, won't go. Oh, they're going to see a foul on Corbin. Somebody Reagan Walker. Hmm. As we like to say, not sure about that one.
Things that make you say,
5:12 to go in the first quarter. North with the ball. Corner shot, no good. Rebound Housley for Corbin. Callie's on the move. Callie gets it across the timeline. Sets it up. Remember, we don't have Bailey Stewart tonight. They don't pick her up. She shoots a three and hits it. Well, that's not something you should do, is leave her alone. 6-4, Corbin on top. 4:43 to go in the first quarter. Sizemore with it. Goes inside, tipped away.
Nice
defense. Nice pass down to Anderson. Darcy goes left and puts it in.
Nice shot.
Not sure why that wasn't a foul.
I would have called it a foul.
That's clear on the other end, so I don't know.
I would have called it one.
Sizemore with it for North. Trying to break free. Kicks it back out. Ball ricochets. I don't think Bella Sizemore was ready for it. Sister to sister there. And for North Laurel, number 35. Is that what that is?
I think.
Gracie McKnight. Anderson has it for Corbin. Gives it off. Housley, long three, got it again.
Oh, yes. What a shot. That was about a four-pointer.
11-4, Corbin with their biggest lead at 7. Down the lane, layup is good by Emily Sizemore. 11-6, Corbin, 3:44 to go. Anderson, Darcy, kicks it in the corner. Another one by Housley, this time she missed.
Oh, following
shot. Rebound by North. They're wanting to move. Sizemore, by the way, shot no good. Rebound, Darcy. It was by Brooke Nicholson, no good.
She walked just a little bit.
Just a little bit. Anderson, no good, but she's fouled. That'll be on 35. That'll be Gracie McKnight. That's her first. I believe the gentleman that was doing the official scores said her and Chloe, and there's a son or boy, their brother. Mm-hmm. There's like triplets.
Oh, wow.
If that's the right family. He was telling me one family has triplets in it, so I'm not sure if I got the right one or not. So if not, there's a family going, I didn't know that. Darcy hits her first and hits the second one. 4 points for her. 13-6 Corbin. 3:22 in the first quarter. Cass Klaus along with Angel Helton. Corbin trying to they go inside. Knocked away again by Reagan Walker. Housley on the move with
defense.
It. Cross courts it to Kylie Clem. Kylie in the lane. Kylie goes up hard, but no call.
Wow.
Back the other way. Reagan breaks it up. And that's it. It's off of Reagan's knee. That may be correct.
Yeah, it was.
It'll be Norse ball. Triggering it in is Bella Sizemore. Sizemore looking, finally gets it in. They're going to get it back to Bella. She goes inside. Shot no good by McKnight. Rebound, jump ball.
And she is playing some defense on her. She's a head and a half taller than her.
I was going to say, she's giving up quite a bit right there.
Good defense by Reagan Walker.
Bella Sizemore with it. Inside, no, she missed the bunny. And it goes out of bounds off of Corbin. Well, McKnight had a good look at it, but just couldn't get it to go. She's gonna go out for a second. Is that you, is that me?
Oh.
Maybe it's my phone.
Oh, gotcha.
Sometimes phones will make things go.
Oh yeah.
Staticky.
That's why I keep mine way over there.
North back with the ball in bounds. 2:39 to go. Oh, stolen away by Kylie Clem. Said she stepped out of bounds. He's right there, so we're not going to argue with him. Number 00 back into the game, Jalen Black. She started the game for North. For the Lady Redhounds, number 24, all right, Izzy Walker comes in and gives Mahala Jordan a rest. 13-6. You know we're back on again tomorrow.
Yes.
Clay County comes to town. Another good game.
Yeah, it will be.
2.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. And Sizemore, shot short. Rebound, Callie Housley. Housley playing good defense. Across the timeline, gives it off. Reagan Walker for the three. Short.
Oh.
Housley kicks it out to herself. She's going to shoot the three. Hurts the short, I can tell from here. Rebound, North. Comes out of there with it. Emily Sizemore with it. Sizemore backs up outside the three-point line. They go inside, knocked away by Reagan Walker. Almost saved it. North comes up with a loose ball. Sizemore fakes. Starts to spin, goes down the lane. Shot is short. Good defense by Housley.
Great defense.
Callie goes off. Izzy Walker to Kylie Clem. Minute 39. Corbin on top, 13-6 here in the first quarter. Emily. Why do I keep calling her Emily?
Kylie?
Yeah, Kylie Clem. Housley down the lane. Spins and lays it in.
She goes when she goes.
There's
nobody stopping her.
You know, her Uncle Rod is supposed to be watching today.
Oh, really?
Down in Tennessee.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. We said we'd give a shout-out to Uncle Rod.
Uncle Rod.
Down the lane, there's going to be a foul. I'm not sure which one they're going to get it on because both of them reached. They're going to give it to Darcy.
She must be playing for Uncle Rod tonight. She's hustling big time.
Back in is Chloe McKnight for North. It'll be North's ball. 15-6, Corbin on top. Minute 10 to go in the first quarter. Comes in bounds. Sizemore, Emily Sizemore. I think she's one of the all-time leading scorers for them. She goes over.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
She goes over to Bella Sizemore, back to Emily. Emily, she's got Housley on her. Hands it off to go inside. Stolen away again by Reagan Walker. Reagan, down to Kylie Clem. They don't call it out of bounds. Jump ball. Oh, no. Foul on Izzy Walker. Izzy Walker picks up that foul.
I don't think you can call a foul when there's no control of the ball.
He did.
He did. But, I mean, you're not supposed to.
Mahala Jordan comes in, gives Callie Housley a rest. Get her a drink of water. North with the ball. Emily Sizemore brings it down. 40 seconds to go. Outside, they try to go inside. They do. They get it. Shot is short. Rebound, Kylie Clem. Kylie gives it off. Dribbling out is Darcy Anderson. 24 seconds. See if we play for one. Darcy starts to her right. Goes down on the floor. The referee says over and back, and Isaac Wilson says, "You don't really think she fell down on the floor on her own, do you?" That may not be what he said, but that's what I would say.
Well, that was what was in his head, if that's not what came out of his mouth.
Yeah.
You can't run into someone and knock them down. And then with the ball, and it not be a foul.
Yeah. Well, Sizemore with it, tries to get loose. Hala's good on her. Other Sizemore shot, no good. Rebound, torquing away. 3 seconds to go. Anderson, long shot at the buzzer. Just missed.
So close.
We have played one exciting first quarter with our score. It's Corbin 15, North Laurel 6. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhounds basketball on WCTT.
Dreaming about enjoying time on the lake but need a boat? Or planning a road trip but not sure which RV is right for you and your family? Wildcat RV and Marine can help. With our selection of Keystone and Crossroads RVs and Mercury Low boats, we can get you in the great outdoors. We're a family-owned RV and Marine dealer with professionally trained sales and service departments. Our staff is committed to helping you find the perfect RV or boat and keep it on the road or in the water. Wildcat RV and Marine, just off I-75 in Corbin, or online at wildcatrvandmarine.com.
Welcome back to L.U. Gillen Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Klaus along with Angel Helton. Corbin on top, 15-6 over North Laurel. Exciting game. I didn't want to interrupt you. What's in the other pan?
refried beans.
Refried
with
beans.
No cheese.
With no cheese.
Listen.
Man, these diets are killing me. Yeah.
This is a doctor-induced thing. This is
Ooh,
not
a
on
doctor?
My own free will.
Oh, wow.
Found out I'm allergic to dairy and gluten.
Oh, that'd be bad.
That's what's been wrong with me. So.
That's what's
I do feel better. I
After
feel
all
better.
These years?
Not that I can eat anything, but I feel better.
Darcy Anderson has the ball for the Lady Hounds. Gives it to Reagan Walker to her left to Kylie Clem. Haley Jordan calls for the ball. She can't get it to her. Darcy's got it on the right. Gives it to Kylie. She starts on her left. Housley saying, I'm open. They go back to her right. Cross courts it to Callie Housley. She sets up the offense. Goes to her right. Whoops, accidentally dribbles it off her foot, but keeps going. Tracks it back down. Starts, dribbles behind her back. Now she's at the top of the key. Goes to her left to Kylie Clem. Kylie.
Oh,
he said she palmed the ball.
Yeah, she did. I seen it.
Well, if you said it's true.
Well, she kind of caught it right
caught
here.
It up, yeah.
When she went to turn, it caught on her side. So, yeah.
15-6, Corbin on top. Sizemore with it. Gives it to Sizemore. See, if they were all named the same thing, it'd be real easy. Inside, shot is up, no good. Chloe McKnight had it under there. She just tried to shoot it too far. Back the other way, Clem. Wow. you got to catch that.
That
thing.
Was close.
Reagan Walker inside. Wow. So foul's going to be called.
I was going to say she flew through the air.
Yeah.
That was a foul. I don't know what is.
Bounce on double zero. And that is Jalen Black. That is her first. At the free throw line to be Reagan Walker. Reagan started this game off for the Lady Hounds by hitting a three-pointer. She'll be going to the free throw line for her first trip there. Free throw is good. You know, Reagan can shoot the three. She has to always play defense inside so much.
Yeah.
You just don't realize how good of a shooter she is.
And she's really playing good defense on that girl, the big girl tonight for North Laurel.
Second one does not want to go. North Laurel pulls out the rebound. Bella Sizemore has it. Gives it off. Off to Emily Sizemore. Emily starts a drive. Cut off there. Gives it back to Bella Sizemore. Bella. Ooh. That pass out there too much. Oh, is that a charge? Oh, no. Did they call it on? Oh, they called it on Reagan Walker.
Ooh. She ran flat over.
Yeah, I thought she was set up there for a charge.
She hollered, how?
Yeah. Coach Wilson.
I'm with you, Reagan. Yeah. I'm with you.
Coach Wilson, of course, doesn't have Bailey Stewart tonight. She's got a knee injury she's recuperating with. First free throw is good by number 21, Brooke Nicholson, sophomore. In comes Izzy Walker, replacing Reagan Walker. We give up a little size and height there. So it could be interesting who will guard Chloe McKnight down below. Second free throw is good by Nicholson. That's her first two, 16-8. Corbin on top, 6:32 to go in the first half. Darcy Anderson with it for the Lady Hounds. Goes to her left to Housley. Housley backs out. No need to be in a hurry. Goes to her right to Darcy, to Kylie Clem. Kylie starts to drive, gives it off to Housley. Housley gives it back to Kylie. She fakes a shot, starts a drive. She's cut off by the good defense. Back the other way, gives it out, and she walks. She switched pivot feet, I thought.
Darcy did?
Yeah. No, not Darcy, but Kylie.
Kylie.
Did I say Darcy?
No.
No.
No, I wasn't sure who had the ball when he called the ball.
Callie Clem had it. 16-8, 6 minutes to go in the first half. Sizemore gives it off to Sizemore. Long three. Good. By number 21, Nicholson. Was that her?
Yep, Brett Nicholson.
Let me tell you, I am not fond of that green on blue. Darcy is, I was going to say, they keep bobbing up to her. And North was wanting something called, but it's really, they're the ones that was doing the foul. Foul was on number 23, Emily Sizemore. That's her first. Corbin's ball underneath their own basket. Anderson trying to get it in. Finally finds Housley. Housley's open for a three, too hard. Rebound, North Laurel. Quickly down court, Sizemore. Emily Sizemore. She's got Housley on her. She's lobbing it inside. Oh, did she not walk? Oh.
They've walked a few times I've seen it. Just a no calls. Just a couple.
Fouls on Izzy Walker, I believe. Who did he call that foul on?
I thought it was Izzy.
I do too. I'm going to write down Izzy. At the free throw line, it'll be 54, Chloe McKnight, the junior. Her first shot is good. 5 points for her. She's tied with Brooke Nicholson for the lead for North Laurel for most points. 16-12, Corbin in the lead. McKnight trying to get North a little closer. Shot no good. Rebound comes all the way out. They give it back to Nicholson. Oh, she hits a jumper from the free throw line. She'd already had a little practice from there. That's the lead to two. Darcy down the court. Rose in!
Needed that.
7 points for Darcy. The Archer comes inside. Turnaround shot. No good. Rebound. Kylie Clem. Kylie. Down court. Gold spins. She's going to be fouled. Corbin's kind of trying to take it to him and make him get in foul trouble here.
Yeah, they're a good defensive team, North is, so you either have to take it to them and get the foul, or they're more than likely to steal it.
At the free throw line, Kylie Clem. She hasn't scored yet tonight. Dribbles a couple times, spins the ball, lets it fly. Ooh, I didn't think that was going in.
I didn't either. It looked off just a little bit.
From this angle, it didn't look too good. But she had just a soft touch. It made its way in. She'll have one more coming to her. Addie Wilson is in the game for Corbin. Number 32. Second shot is up and short. I thought that one was going in. Oh, excellent defense.
By Kelly Housley. Awesome.
Emily Sizemore did not see her, then all of a sudden caught the side of her eye when she ran in front of her, and it caused her to stutter.
If she'd have put the ball down, she'd have got
stolen,
it too.
Yeah. Yep. Corbin's ball underneath their own basket. Darcy kicks it in. They give it back to her. Takes it down the lane. Ball. Oh, wow. Now, I'll tell you what. That was not a foul.
That was a stuff.
Chloe McKnight's going to pick up that foul. Kind of feel sorry for her because that really was a nice block, I thought.
It was, if she would have just not got her body on her, it was a really good block.
Did she get her body?
Well, that's when she fell. She kind of bodied up, but it was a good block.
But when the whistle blew, I thought she'd reached over and did a pretty good job. First free throw by Darcy is good. 8 points for her.
That ball just looks like it is not going in from this angle.
Yeah, I don't know. Is the rim round?
That might be the one that's messed up.
One more free throw. Got them both.
Nice.
Need every point. 22-14. Yes. Corbin. 4:44 to go in the first half. Emily Sizemore goes to Sis Sizemore. Whoop, almost. They work it around. Corbin still in the man-to-man. Drive. Ball knocked away. Corbin comes up with a loose ball. Kylie Clem. She's in a hurry. Kylie Clem. Oh, the roof ball is blocked. Addie Wilson comes up with it. Gives it to Jordan, who gives it to Anderson. Three!
Yes. Nice.
Good ball movement.
We needed that.
12 points for Darcy. Backdoor play by North Laurel. Oh, nice play. Gives it off to Sizemore. Emily Sizemore shot good. 5 points for her. 25-17, Corbin. Darcy, nobody picks her up. Oh, it did not go. Tipped inside to Housley.
I didn't see no walk in there.
She was dribbling. I'm not sure. Maybe he was late on his whistle. Maybe he thought he saw it earlier. Because she was dribbling when he blew
his
whistle.
Maybe he just missed it. Sorry.
Emily Sizemore brings it down for North Laurel. Gives it off to Bella Sizemore. Shot good. That's Emily Sizemore. Bella gave it back to her. 8 points for her. 25-20, Corbin by 5, 3:25 to go. Like we said, this is a could be a pretty good, a very good game in the region. Housley, long three, won't go. Rebound North. Quickly down court to Emily Sizemore. Cross courts it. Long three, good. By number 21, Brooke Nicholson.
Can't believe her open.
Corbin's lead is down to 2. Darcy Anderson. Darcy starts to her left, gets a pick from Mahala. Gives it to Kylie. Gives it out to Addie. Addie, who? Addie's knocked down, goes back to her play to Kylie Clemmer, lays it in.
Nice.
Nice play by Addie Wilson. She was on her. Back the other way, shot no good. Rebound Anderson. This is a, hey, this is a lot of tension here, just like a big region game. Ball comes out to Darcy Anderson. Darcy has, they went for the steal and couldn't get it. They got Addie Lee Wilson in the corner. North's
it's getting a little heated in here.
North has brought a lot of fans.
Yeah, they have. This is a good ball game.
As we said, it's nothing but bragging
rights.
Darcy's
getting tickled down
there. Darcy brings it, throws it in to Callie. Housley has it. Top of the key, starts left, goes right. Backs up. Starts to drive again. She's bumped. Gets rid of it to Darcy. Anderson spins in the lane. Oh, it won't go. Rebound. Mahala Jordan gives it off to Darcy. Darcy off the glass and in. Time out, Corbin. Time on the floor with our score. It's Corbin 29, North World 23. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
Our world has dramatically changed over the past couple of years. We've all had to adjust to these changing times. But one thing that has not changed is the fact that the Hart family and Tri-County Cycle Sales is still serving southeastern Kentucky with the same quality products and service after the sale since 1968. Honda, Yamaha, Kawasaki, and Polaris are the biggest names in off-road adventure and can still be found at Tri-County Cycle Sales. For your next ATV or side-by-side, stop by the place where time has stood still. Tri-County Cycle Sales, located between Corbin and London on US 25 across from Kentucky Outdoorsman.
Welcome back to L.U. Gillum Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Klaus along with Angel Helton. We've got a good one. 29-23. Corbin on top of North Laurel. Minute 58 to go here in the first half. Emily Sizemore will bring it down for the North Laurel Lady Jags. Goes over to Sis. Inside. No, I think Mahala is going to get called for the foul.
Yeah, she had her hand on the ball, but you can't reach in and let him.
Brooke Nicholson says, was I shooting?
No, I don't think so.
It'll be Norse ball underneath their own basket. Trying to get it inbounds. They get it to Nicholson. They get back to her. She starts to drive in the, oh, in the lane. Kicks it back out. Sizemore in the corner. No good. Oh, Nicholson gets that rebound. Oh, she missed. Ball goes back out. Kylie Clem's got it. Kylie, slow down. Ball knocked away. Kylie says, you got, oh, yeah, that's what I thought. Coach Wilson thought, Coach Wilson said somebody hit it. I did you see anybody hit it? They called me for double dribble. Coach Wilson says there's, said it got hit. There's no way it's double dribble. So turnover anyway.
Coach Wilson's, no, I didn't
his vote
that.
Didn't count. So.
No. No more than ours,
no
actually.
No more than ours. Bella Sizemore with it. Holds it over her head. Goes to her left. Now backs up. Goes to her right to Nicholson. Cross courts it to Emily Sizemore. 11 points for her. And North draws again within 3. 29-26 with 54 seconds to go in the first half. Darcy Anderson starts the drive. Has it knocked out of her hands. Spins. Dribbles behind her back, goes to her right, gets a pick from Mahala. They're just tossing her around. Housley has it. She starts the drive, gives it out. Kylie Clem, 37 seconds. Kylie backs out near the Paul's print. Nice defense by North. Kylie gives out the three. Wow!
What a shot!
6 points. That was from another area.
That was a 5 or 6 point. I'm not sure.
32-26, 18 seconds. Emily Sizemore brings it down. Goes to Bella Sizemore. They go cross courts it. Long one shot, no good. Nicholson with the rebound, 6 seconds to go. Nicholson in the lane. Let's see who called the foul on.
32.
I think it's Addie Wilson.
Yeah.
For Addie, that's her first at the free throw line. Be number 21, Brooke Nicholson. 8 points for her on the night. She's just a sophomore. They got a young team.
She's a good player, too.
9 points for her. Coach Eddie Mayhem. Graduate of Corbin High School.
Yes, he's a great guy. Great guy.
Hits them both. 10 points for Nicholson. 2 seconds left. Darcy. Oh, a little short. We have played 2 quarters with our score. It's Corbin 32, North Laurel 28. We'll be back in 2 minutes. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
I hate box springs. Well, here at Sammy's Furniture, we hate them so much, when you buy any mattress $7.99 and up, we're going to give you one for free. So if you're thinking, yeah, Sammy's right, if box springs were a person, I would punch them in the face. Well, guess what? You can take the price of that box spring and deduct it from any adjustable base we've got in the store, and we've got over 16 of them. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture and Mattress. Folks, we're open 7 days a week from 10 to 6, Sundays from 12 to 5. We've got 12 months same as cash financing if you need it. When you pick it up, you get an extra discount on top of a free box spring that we can't wait to get out of here. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture.
Dear past, present, and future football watchers, you know why we're here. The football season is back! Woo! And since that's too amazing to miss a single second's worth, Pepsi is officially giving you permission to always put football first. Like, maybe those in-laws are back in town. Well, better hope they're football fans, because your Sunday is completely booked. Long story short, crack open a Pepsi and don't let anything get between you and your football watching. With love, Pepsi. Made for football watching. That's what I like.
Get relief from your migraine headaches with Dr. Deidre Pennington at Pennington Wellness Chiropractic and Massage. Don't suffer for years as my wife did with monthly medications that work sometimes. Since she has been seeing Dr. Pennington, her migraines have gone away. And this is someone who had suffered for more than a decade and is now migraine-free with no monthly medications. Migraine headaches can go away with a trip to Pennington Wellness Chiropractic and Massage. Located at 615 South Main Street in Corbin. Phone 606-261-2053.
Hometown Bank is proud of their name because Hometown Bank is proud of the hometowns they're in. In fact, their name is their mission, which is to take care of the communities in which they work and live. Hometown Bank is always here to help, so if you're buying a house, remodeling your kitchen, or need a home equity loan to combine other debt, come see Hometown Bank and find out how easy working with a Hometown Bank can be. Visit the Hometown Bank nearest you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Welcome back to LU Gillum Memorial Gymnasium. It's halftime. Gus Klaus along with Angel Helton Corbin with a slim 32-28 game, a lead, and it has been an entertaining game.
Yes, it has. Yes. I love those kind of games.
You want to give them the story?
Sure. We got Darcy Anderson with 14 for the Corbin Lady Redhounds, Callie Clem with 6, Callie Housley with 8, and Reagan Walker with 4. And for the Lady Jaguars, we've got Chloe McKnight with 7, Brooke Nicholson with 10, and Emily Sizemore with 8.
So I have Emily with 11. Let's see.
Oh, maybe you're right.
Yeah, that makes 28. Yeah.
She's got that 3 right there at the end. You're right.
That's only 3 players for North Laurel that have scored. So
you wouldn't know it to watch them play.
No, you'd think everybody's dishing the ball and getting shots at it, but they have just 3 players have scored. Corbin, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 players have scored. As we said, in case you're listening, you say, well, I don't hear Bailey's name. Bailey hurt her knee the last game, and it's not is out of this game.
Yeah, and she's a crucial loss to the team. Yeah. Bailey contributes a lot. If she's not having a scoring night, she's having a defensive night. Either way, she's always noticed on the floor.
Music being played here. The band is not here. They were out there practicing. They must be going somewhere to perform somewhere.
They were
practicing out there in the area when you first come in. If you come in the southern, no, that'd be the eastern door.
In the door down where I park.
There you go. The door down around where you park.
Where the buses
come in.
That's right.
Corbin on top, 32-28. And sent a message to Ronnie Helton, trying to find out how Ronnie Helton. Ronnie Smith, boy, I am lost on names. My memory medicine has ran out. I got to get my memory medicine.
My memory medicine.
I'll blame it on something. So right now, we're going to take another timeout. We're going to take a two-minute timeout. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhounds on WCTT.
Appalachian Wireless has a plan to make your life simpler. It's called Forward Pay. No contract, no credit check, no problem. Plans start at $19.99 a month and includes unlimited talk and text. Add 3 gigabytes of data, $29.99 per month. 6 gigabytes, $39.99 per month. Or take it to the max with unlimited data plus. Just $89.99 per month with 50 gigabytes of high-speed data. All the features of postpaid service without the long-term commitment. It's Forward Pay because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Unlimited data plus, close to 1 megabyte per second. Past 50 gigabytes of use.
Our world has dramatically changed over the past couple of years. We've all had to adjust to these changing times. But one thing that has not changed is the fact that the Hart Family and Tri-County Cycle Sales is still serving southeastern Kentucky with the same quality products and service after the sale since 1968. Honda, Yamaha, Kawasaki, and Polaris are the biggest names in off-road adventure and can still be found at Tri-County Cycle Sales. For your next ATV or side-by-side, stop by the place where time has stood still. Tri-County Cycle Sales, located between Corbin and London on US 25 across from Kentucky Outdoorsman.
I hate box springs. Well, here at Sammy's Furniture, we hate them so much, when you buy any mattress $7.99 and up, we're going to give you one for free. So if you're thinking, yeah, Sammy's right, if box springs were a person, I would punch them in the face. Well, guess what? You can take the price of that box spring and deduct it from any adjustable base we've got in the store, and we've got over 16 of them. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture and Mattress. Folks, we're open 7 days a week from 10 to 6, Sundays from 12 to 5. We've got 12 months, same as cash financing if you need it. When you pick it up, you get an extra discount on top of a free box spring that we can't wait to get out of here. Come see us today at Sammy's Furniture.
Dear past, present, and future football watchers, you know why we're here. The football season is back! Woo! And since that's too amazing to miss a single second's worth, Pepsi is officially giving you permission to always put football first. Like, maybe those in-laws are back in town. Well, better hope they're football fans because your Sunday is completely booked. Long story short, crack open a Pepsi and don't let anything get between you and your football watching. With love, Pepsi. Made for football watching. That's what I like.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to LU Gillen Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Klaus, along with Angel Helton. Corbin holds a 32-28 advantage over the North Laurel Lady Jags. And Angel, here's my funny story on Coach Eddie Mahan of North Laurel.
So, you what? Say that again?
Here's my funny story about Coach Eddie Mahan of North Laurel. So before the game started, I was getting the numbers and everything, making sure all my numbers were correct with the scorekeeper from North Laurel. And I said, you know, and Eddie was sitting there, he couldn't hear me. I said, you know, I coached Eddie when he was young in Optimus basketball. he said, really? He said, was he a good player? I said, sure was a nice kid. So he tells Eddie, he says, that's what everybody says. He says, they never say how good I was. I was a nice
kid.
Yeah. And then when I'm walking over to come up the staircase later on, you know, his team is waiting to come on the floor. And I said, hey, girls, I used to be your coach's basketball coach. He said, don't tell any stories. I said, was he any good? I said, oh, he was great. He was great.
He was a great.
Great player. Yeah, I could. Well, I didn't tell him that because that would just crush him there.
Oh, goodness.
North is back on the floor, warming up. Corbin getting ready to come out. Second half, really, we have Reagan Walker got into a little foul trouble. She had two fouls on her, but really, Izzy come off the bench and helped out. And And Addie Wilson came in. So even though we lost her, they were able to hold on.
Yeah, she was sure playing some tough defense in the first half.
Corbin hopefully can shoot like they did the first half. And to hold North to 28 points, I think it's pretty good, because you're talking about the top scoring team in the region.
Absolutely. Oh, I've got a question.
Uh-oh. How old are you?
Are you scared?
Yeah, I am scared. Anytime you ask a question.
Didn't I see just not long ago on your page, you might have had an anniversary?
I did.
And
I
how
did.
Long has Glenda put up with you?
Poor woman. 40.
Oh, you better get it right. 40, Glenda, I hope 41. You're listening.
No, she never
did
listens.
Did you say 40-11?
41.
You said 40-11.
Yeah. And I have a big event tomorrow.
You do?
I do. Tomorrow's my birthday.
And you'll be 40-11?
No. I can't say I'll be 35, so I'm just...
You'll have a 5 on the end, though? Is that what you're trying to say?
32-28, Corbin. Where do those years go, you know?
Tell me about it.
Okay. Both teams gathered around their coaches getting final words. You know, Corbin beat them during the WYMT Mountain Classic, and it was a good game. I tuned in and watched it on my computer and stuff, and that was a good game.
This is a great game.
Yeah, well, these two teams, these are really, except for North having a little bit better height, and I think we have better shooters. They're pretty two even teams.
Yes, very competitive teams.
It'll be North's ball starting this second half. Bella Sizemore gives it to Emily Sizemore, and she brings it down, sets it up for North. Right now, they got Corbin's same starting lineups. Inside, layup is good. Zach Nicholson. Brooke Nicholson scores her 12. Darcy Anderson brings it down. Corbin up by 2. Anderson gives it off. Reagan Walker, 3. No good. Rebound. Bella Sizemore for North. Kicks it off quickly. Gets it off to Black. In the corner, long 3, no good. Rebound. Yep. Chloe McKnight lost it. I think we had a hold of it, and then she kind of pulled it away from the player. When she did, it went out of bounds. Corbin's ball. Darcy Anderson brings it down. Darcy gives it off to Reagan Walker. Reagan gives it off to Mahala Jordan. Jordan gives it back. Housley, no good. Rebound.
It's on the run a little.
Emily Sizemore with the rebound. Sizemore, Reagan Walker. Don't pick up a foul back there. Sizemore has it tipped, gets it, puts it in.
Wow.
Nice spinning move.
That was nice.
By the senior. 13 points for her. We're tied at 32. Reagan Walker has it. Drives the lane. Layup. Oh, she missed it. Mahala Jordan. No. Coach Wilson says what we all say. You get a rebound, go back up and shoot it.
Yes.
She started coming back out of there with it. I don't know why she just didn't go back up. Coach Wilson isn't sure either. He's kind of getting some water.
He needs water. He needs water. Someone get him some water.
Emily Sizemore brings it down for the Lady Jaguars. We're tied at 32 here at LU Gillum on a Friday night. Long one by Sizemore. No good. Rebound by Nicholson. Cross courts it, stolen away by Darcy. Gives it off. I'm trying to Reagan Walker, and she's fouled. Keep cool. I think Bella Sizemore, that's her second.
I think he's backing them up. He's afraid of the foul trouble. Yeah.
Darcy Anderson brings it down. Looks for the play. Starts to her right, gives it off to Reagan Walker at the top of the key. She goes over to Mahala Jordan, gives it to Callie Housley. Housley backs up. Housley's got Black on her. Starts to her right, down to her left. Oh, crosses her over. Oh, spins in the lane. Oh, missed the shot. And then she commits the foul. Well, it's a nice move.
Wow.
It's her first. According to my paperwork, and I think that's what Larry said. Larry Dickerson being the PA announcer tonight.
Yeah. Emily's, he's a good PA announcer.
He is a good one. I figured he'd be over at Jackson County. Maybe we'll. Emily Sizemore down the lane, lays it up and in. North Rowell has the lead, 34-32. Housley with it for Corbin, loses the ball. And then she's fouled by Nicholson, who was diving for the ball. That's one of those things where you get called for hustling.
Yeah.
Kylie Clem will be triggered it in for the Lady Hounds. Kylie looking for someone open, bounces it in to Jordan, gives it off to Anderson. Anderson has her shot blocked. McKnight got her hand on it. Back the other way, Sizemore. North wants a foul every time you breathe. Down the lane, shot no good, rebound. North comes out there with it. Sizemore gives it off to Sizemore. Shot no good, rebound. Up and in by Chloe McKnight. 9 points for her. North has come out fired up. Ball out to Housley for a three. No good. We've gone cold. Bella Sizemore brings it down for North Laurel. Gives it back to Emily Sizemore. She'll walk it across the timeline. 36-32. North has the lead. 4:28 to go in the third. Emily Sizemore being guarded by Reagan Walker. Gives it off to Nicholson. Nichols, wow, she hit that three.
Can't let that girl shoot a three.
Coach Wilson calls the play. Anderson bumped, does not score, but she picks up a foul on Emily Sizemore. That's her second. And that may be what Coach is thinking about doing is letting them drive on them and picking them up some foul trouble here.
Yeah, that's probably
we have not
a
scored.
Good plan.
We've played 4 minutes and have not scored. There we go. In the first half, second half. Darcy hits the first free throw. That's 15 points for her. 39-33. North in the lead. 4:07 to go in the third. Anderson, one more free throw. Oh, too hard. Rebound. North, long three, boom. And that's number double zero. Jalen Black, that's her first points of the night. Down the other way, turn around in the lane, no good.
Follow your shot.
Anderson. Gonna get frustrated now. 9 point lead all of a sudden by North in the corner. Well, their shot missed this time, but Emily Sizemore pulls off the rebound for them. She gets it out. Again, Black for the long three, no good. Rebound, Reagan Walker for Corbin. Reagan gets it down to Emily, or Kylie Clem. Kylie out to Reagan Walker. Reagan takes it down the lane, lays it up, no good. Rebound, North Laurel.
We've got
to hit the boards. 42-33, North in the lead with 3:06. Corbin led by 4 points at halftime. Nicholson gives it off to Emily Sizemore. Sizemore. These teams could very, almost had her pocket picked by Housley. Now it is. Knocked away by Anderson and picked up by Housley. Housley comes down court quickly. Fakes a pass, gets fouled in the lane. That should be on Jalen Black. It is. I have Herbert, too. That's four team fouls for the half.
Whew. Oh, hate it in here.
It's pretty noisy for just a regular game. And yeah. The crowd's not that, you know.
Yeah.
Not that big, but boy, they're making the noise. 9 points for Kylie Housley. She'll have one more coming to her, trying to get into double figures. Her second shot is up. Got it.
Yeah.
Need every free throw you can get.
Yes.
42-35 cuts it to 7 here in this third quarter. Emily Sizemore brings it down. Sizemore taking her time, waiting to set it up. They go inside. They kick it out. They whip it around. Black has it. She's at the top of the key. Gives it back to Emily Sizemore. Sizemore got Kylie Klim on her. Sizemore tries to get down the lane. Oh, she got loose and put it in and got fouled. How about it was so close to being stolen. Kylie Klim picks up her first foul. Did you not see that it looked like she's just about ready to get it stolen?
Yes. Well,
and then they hit it.
I thought
and then
it
she
was
picked
stolen.
Up the loose ball, yeah. Old-fashioned three-point play, 18 points. North up by 10, 45-35. Corbin with the ball, 2:13 to go. Don't get it. Now's not the time to get frustrated. They give it off in the corner. Anderson whips it to Housley. Housley for that three.
Oh.
Won't go. Rebound. Nicholson comes out of there with it and gives it back to Emily Sizemore. They seem to do better if they let Sizemore run the show.
Yeah.
Gives it to Nicholson. Anderson on her. Nicholson's going to drive. Shot no good. And they're going to call Reagan Walker for the foul.
We're either going to have to set up and take the charge,
stop
them from driving to the basket.
Because they're not getting past us. They're in front of us, so they could easily get a charging call on them.
Yeah.
Free throws up, no good. By the sophomore, Brooke Nicholson, 15 points. She's come alive in the second half. 45-35. North is in the lead. Minute 42 to go in the third. Shot no good. Reagan Walker clears it for Corbin. She's going to go ahead and bring it down. Gives it off to Housley. Housley starts to the right. Fakes the pass. Goes up. Shot won't go. Oh, gosh. No good. Reagan Walker. And timeout on the floor with a score. It's Corbin 45. North Laurel 45. Corbin 35. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
Have you been having problems with your golf swing because of pain? As a lifelong golfer, I understand how back or neck pain can affect your game. Did you know specific chiropractic treatment can help? Call and make an appointment with me, Dr. Deidre Pennington, and see why so many people are raving about Pennington Wellness Chiropractic and Massage. Phone 606-261-2053. Take a swing at being pain-free with Pennington Wellness.
If you're having problems, trust our Grammy.
We do!
Welcome back to L.U. Gillum Memorial Gymnasium. North Laurel has sprinted to a 45-35 lead. Corbin has only scored 3 points this quarter, and North Laurel has scored 17. And Angel, you can't beat a good team with scoring like that.
Absolutely not. You have to score, or not let them score either.
Yeah.
One or the other.
Corbin's ball underneath the Corbin basket. Darcy Anderson throws it in, stolen away. I guess that she stepped out of bounds. It'll be go back to Corbin. Some of the North fans are up. Oh, there's plenty of referees for both teams. Ball comes into Kylie Klim. Kylie spins. Oh, she shot it too hard. Oh, mercy. She'd like to have that one back.
Ooh.
Emily Sizemore brings it down, throws it off. They give it out to Bella Sizemore. Bella goes in the corner to Black. Back to Bella. To Emily Sizemore. Corbin did a little trapping. Black has it. Gives it out to Bella Sizemore. 59 seconds. She's on the floor. She lost her shoe. What was the call? You can't call. Whoa! He's calling a fit. Did they call timeout? We'll stay right
here.
She
called a timeout once she hit the floor.
Once she hit the floor. Okay. So North Park calls timeout so she can put her shoe back on. You know, that'd be a timeout they may like to have later on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I guess it was that or lose the ball.
Yeah. So Bella Sizemore, She's got one of the coaches putting her tying her shoe forward. Hey, that's pretty nice.
He's doing something different, I guess, so they don't come untied.
From the double knot. 45-35, North with the ball and the lead. Starting at halftime, Corbin led by four, but North come out shooting, and Corbin has been ice cold. Third quarter has not been our friend tonight.
Whew, not at all.
Bella Sizemore throw it into Emily Sizemore. Sizemore across the timeline. 52 seconds to go. Corbin traps a little bit. They give it to Nicholson in the corner to Black. Back to Nicholson. To Sizemore. Turnaround jumper. No good. Oh, how'd she get the rebound? Oh, shot up and in.
Wow.
By Chloe McKnight. Yeah, she walked several times right there. Not sure.
They walked a few times tonight.
47-35. North in the lead. Darcy Anderson with it. Gives it off to Housley. Housley's three won't go. We are just ice cold. Black with the rebound. Gives it off to Emily Sizemore. Emily has it deflected by Kylie Clem. Kylie steals it. Goes all the way and lays it in. 8 points for Kylie Clem. 4 seconds to go. Sizemore. Long three. No good. And that's the end of the third quarter with our score. It's North Laurel 47, Corbin 37. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
Hometown Bank is proud of their name because Hometown Bank is proud of the hometowns they're in. In fact, their name is their mission, which is to take care of the communities in which they work and live. Hometown Bank is always here to help, so if you're buying a house, remodeling your kitchen, or need a home equity loan to combine other debt, come see Hometown Bank and find out how easy working with a Hometown Bank can be. Visit the Hometown Bank nearest you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Welcome back to LU Gillum Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Klaus along with Angel Heltman. Corbin trails starting this fourth quarter, 47-37. We don't want to break our streak. We haven't called a losing game this year.
Not this year.
So.
I'm blaming it on Bailey.
Bailey being out.
I'm blaming it on Bailey.
Yeah. Poor Bailey.
Poor Bailey.
Corbin's ball to start this fourth quarter of play. We were outscored by 14 points that quarter.
Yes.
So we got to just return the favor.
She definitely contributes to the floor, I'll tell you that.
Housley with the ball for Corbin. Gives it off to Anderson. Anderson starts the drive, tries to give it back to Housley, and it's stolen. They saw that one coming. Emily
wow.
Sizemore did. And Sizemore gives it off to Black. Ball knocked away from Nicholson. Nicholson goes inside to not stolen away. Anderson, long pass to Kylie Clem. Kylie fakes one way, goes the other way. Oh, and missed the
wow.
shot. Reagan Walker, wow, there we go.
Reagan will keep taking it for the last
she's a battler. It's one of them nights where Kylie Clem's shots weren't good. She's got 8 points. But she's got to had a couple of them I'm sure she'd like to have back that just would not come in. Reagan Walker, 4 points on the night. Hit the very first basket for Corbin. And has missed
hard.
The last two free throws. She's one of three from the free throw line. 47-37, North Laurel in the lead, 7:23 to go in your game. Second one is up and got that one.
Good.
5 points for the sophomore. North Laurel with the ball. Emily Sizemore brings it down. Sizemore goes over to Bella Sizemore. Bella looking. Oh, goes inside.
Oh.
Nice pass to Chloe McKnight.
Nobody on.
She just had one of those no-look passes. She knew that McKnight was open. Darcy got it.
Nice.
That's what we need, 18 points from Darcy Anderson. And you get her and Housley and Clem all hot. Shoot themselves right back in this game. Down by eight, 49-41. Ball goes inside to Emily Sizemore, to Bella Sizemore for a three. No good. They try to block out. Oh, my goodness, McKnight. She got the rebound and put it back in. They were working on her, but just couldn't keep her out. 15 points for her. Kylie Clem thinks about a three. Does not go. Anderson shot. Oh, along the baseline. No good. Shot it right over the goal. Down the court. Here comes Nicholson. She backs it back out. Gives it to Black. Almost stolen by Kylie Clem. Ball will be out of bounds to North. 51-41. North in the lead over Corbin. 6:16 to go. Ball comes in bounds to Emily Sizemore. Corbin has defeated them the last two times. North is trying to return the favor here.
Yeah.
Nicholson to Bella Sizemore. She starts to drive. Her shot, a little short, deflected. Darcy Anderson comes out of there with it for Corbin. I'm not sure who all got the hands on it, but goes to Mahala Jordan. Mahala back to Darcy. Darcy backs out of there. Calls the play. She wants Mahala on the right. She starts down the lane. Shot off the glass. No good. A little short. Nice drive. Coming back all the way down is Emily Sizemore for North Laurel. Sizemore has it. Goes cross courts to Black. Out to Nicholson. Inside to Sizemore. Back to Bella Sizemore. Her three. Gosh. They're not missing right now.
They're not.
Corbin back the other way. Housley's shot blocked. Northrop back the other way. Stolen, then stolen back. Foul's going to be called on Darcy Anderson. We're getting a little frustrated with each other. Gosh,
yeah.
North has got a 13-point lead. We cut it down to 8 just a little while ago.
It was down to 7 at one point.
54-41. North in the lead. 5 minutes to go. See what we can do this last 5 minutes of the game. Ball stolen away by Reagan Walker. She's got it. Oh, she got bumped out there by Bella Sizemore. They call it on her for reaching in. I've got her with 3.
Got her with 3?
Yeah. Corbin's ball on the side. Housley will trigger it in. Tomorrow we'll be back on the air with Clay County. Always a good game. Comes out to Housley. Housley gets a pick from Reagan Walker. Gives it off to Darcy Anderson. Darcy in the lane. Tough shot.
Yes.
Got it. 20 points for Darcy. 54-43. Corbin trails by 11. Sizemore brings it down. Gives it off to Bella Sizemore. They give it in the corner to Black. Cross courts it. Ooh, to Nicholson. She launches a 3. Gosh, she got it again. Brooke Nicholson, 18 points. This is why they're one of the leading scoring teams. We had them. We kept them down.
I don't think they've missed a shot.
They only scored
this last little bit.
Kylie Clem starts the drive. Gathered 3 Baylors around her. Housley tries to drive, and she's tripped. North players help her up. Let's see who they've decided it's on. 21. Oh, Brooke Nicholson, that's their second. Callie Housley at the free throw line. 10 points on the night for the junior.
You know, both teams, kudos to both teams. They've played great games so far and still great sportsmanship. I love to see that.
Housley at the line. First free throw is up and good.
Nice shot.
57-44. Corbin trails by 13. Still time to go. 4 minutes to go. I'll tell you what, with a 3-point shot, you're never out of this game. Second one's good. 12 points. Timeout, North Laurel. Timeout on the floor with our score. It's North Laurel 57, Corbin 45. We'll be back in 60 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhounds on WCTT.
Appalachian Wireless has a plan to make your life simpler. It's called Forward Pay. No contract, no credit check, no problem. Plans start at $19.99 a month and includes unlimited talk and text. Add 3 gigabytes of data, $29.99 per month. 6 gigabytes, $39.99 per month. Or take it to the max with unlimited data plus. Just $89.99 per month with 50 gigabytes of high-speed data. All the features of postpaid service without the long-term commitment. It's Forward Pay because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless. Unlimited data plus, close to 1 megabyte per second. Past 50 gigabytes of use.
Welcome back to LUVM Gymnasium. Gus Glass along with Angel Hilton. North Lowe clinging to a 57-45 lead of the Lady Redhounds. The number one and number two of the teams in the region. And they're showing you why. These two teams are tough.
Yes, they are.
Bella Sizemore will trigger it in. Corbin with a full-court press. Sizemore looking, gets it in to Nicholson. Nicholson gets past Anderson. They toss it inside. Shot blocked. Knocked away by Mahala. Oh, she tossed it inbounds to Nicholson. They give it inside. Shot is no good. Reagan Walker pulls it down. Chloe McKnight had two good looks at it. Chloe gives it off. They give it to Darcy. Darcy gives it to Housley. Callie fakes a shot. Gives it off to Kylie Clem. Kylie, long three. Won't go. Rebound.
Rushing the shots.
That one there, she was kind of guarded.
Yeah.
3:15 to go. Sizemore has it for North Laurel. The senior. 57-45. North in the lead. And with the ball. Looking inside to McKnight. They decide not to do it. Nicholson has it. Oh, she double dribbled. She lost it for a second. Stuck her hand in there to kind of balance it and stuff, and then skipped on dribbling. And you know it was so fast. You know you could hardly catch it.
If you wouldn't have been right there, you wouldn't have caught it.
You wouldn't have got it.
No.
Anderson, because the coach didn't say a word over there. They knew she'd done it. Housley for a three, no good. Rebound. Kylie Clem puts it in. 10 points for Kylie Clem. 57-47. It's down to 10. 2.5 minutes to go. Ball stolen away. Darcy Anderson has it. Darcy lays it in. They're looking for the foul there, but they didn't get it. 22 points. Nicholson stolen by Darcy Anderson. Housley gives it to Kylie Clem, who puts it in. Time out, North Laurel. With our score, it's North Laurel 57, Corbin 51. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
Dreaming about enjoying time on the lake but need a boat, or planning a road trip but not sure which RV is right for you and your family? Wildcat RV and Marine can help. With our selection of Keystone and Crossroads RVs and Mercury Low boats, we can get you in the great outdoors. We're a family-owned RV and Marine dealer with professionally trained sales and service departments. Our staff is committed to helping you find the perfect RV or boat and keep it on the road or in the water. Wildcat RV and Marine, just off I-75 in Corbin, or online at wildcatrvandmarine.com.
One. Welcome back to LU Gillen Memorial Gymnasium. Gus Glass along with Angel Hill.
Wow. What a turnaround and that quick.
North Lowell leads 57-51. Corbin, that full court press is shaking North Lowell up just a little bit.
Yeah, maybe we should have started that a couple minutes ago.
Still a lot of time left. 57-51. 6-point lead for North Laurel. Bella Sizemore will trigger it in for North. She got Emily in front of her. See what they do. Sizemore set a pick for Nicholson. They get it into her. Nicholson brings it down. They said that she stepped out of bounds. They didn't call it. Black, a long three, no good. But Kylie Clem pulls down the rebound. Kylie slows down. Now she goes a little faster. Kicks it off to Mahala. Mahala down the lane. Oh, she played it up too short. North with the rebound. Black, she's in trouble. She's in trouble. Finally stolen away by Kylie Clem. Kylie. Anderson, she's fouled. And Joy, she stepped out of bounds.
Wow.
It's a Jalen Black.
I thought that was a
North
foul.
Stepped out of bounds. It was.
I thought it was.
Into the game for North.
At least that's what I'd have called it.
Number 35, Gracie McKnight, who started the game. It'll be Corbin's ball underneath the basket. Corbin runs an out-of-bounds play. Oh, gosh. What was the foul call?
Kelly took the charge. Wow, what that was a smart play. Did you see what she done? Did you see what Callie Housley done?
She got run over, yeah.
She knew the play, and she let them run over her and took the charge to get the shot.
It's a 1-1 bonus.
Wow.
So Callie Housley goes to free throw line.
Nice play.
12 points on the night. Shot is up. Ooh, it doesn't go in. Rebound, North Lowell. Jump ball. No, they call a foul. It'll be on Housley. That's her second. Boy, that ball stood on that rim forever.
Yeah, Ed.
Izzy Walker comes in for Darcy Anderson. Not sure. Ball be. Izzy may be the designated fouler.
Yeah, she might be.
We used to have kids like that. You'd send them into the game. That's the only reason they're in there. Ball comes in bounds. North has it. Ball comes. Nicholson with it. Drives. Jordan, they're going to call Mahalo for the foul. I think so. At the free throw line will be number 21, Brooke Nicholson. Good outside shooter. Hit two free throws earlier there. Four free throws earlier. Whoop, missed that one. Anderson comes back in. Izzy may come in on defense, and then Darcy on offense. One more free throw for Nicholson, 57-51 North. She missed them both. Rebound, Sizemore out hustles Corbin for the for the rebound. In the lane, she kicks it back out to Nicholson, a minute 30 to go. They give it back to Emily Sizemore.
Gotta do something quick.
Darcy's on her, Sizemore. Left-hand dribble down the lane. Shot is she's fouled. She missed it, but she was fouled by Reagan Walker. It's her fourth.
Her fourth?
I have her with four. At the free throw line, be Emily Sizemore. Sizemore's shot is up. Ooh, missed it.
Wow.
Wow. Wow. Got to block out and get the rebound. We got out rebounded this last time right down there.
Got to block out. Got to block out.
Minute 19 to go in the game. North by six, by seven. Sizemore hits the second one, 19 points. Quickly, Housley down to Anderson. Anderson, not a lot of time. Anderson kicks it out. They go over to Housley. Housley for a three. Nope. Rebound. Kylie Clem. I didn't get to see what happened. She lost it out of bounds. When they get right underneath this, it's hard to see the floor. It'll be Sizemore triggering it in. Minute six, got to have a steal. Sizemore looking for getting it in. She gets it into Emily Sizemore. Emily being guarded by Callie Housley. Ooh, almost. They still don't have it across, and they're going to call timeout. Timeout on the floor with their score. It's North Laurel 58, Corbin 51. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Corbin Lady Redhound Basketball on WCTT.
Our world has dramatically changed over the past couple of years. We've all had to adjust to these changing times. But one thing that has not changed is the fact that the Hart Family and Tri-County Cycle Sales is still serving southeastern Kentucky with the same quality products and service after the sale since 1968. Honda, Yamaha, Kawasaki, and Polaris are the biggest names in off-road adventure and can still be found at Tri-County Cycle Sales. For your next ATV or side-by-side, stop by the place where time has stood still. Tri-County Cycle Sales, located between Corbin and London on US 25 across from Kentucky Outdoorsman.
Welcome back to L.U. Gillum Memorial Gymnasium. Under a minute, Des Klaus along with Angel Helton. North Laurel leads Corbin 58-51. It is Norris ball. I think they called timeout because I think they were afraid they were getting close to a 10-second count.
Yeah, well, and she had nowhere to go with the ball.
Kylie Clem is walking all the way with the they get it in bounds. Oh, and then she reaches in. Kylie, that's her second. At the free throw line, it'll be Emily Sizemore. She's 1-for-2 last time she was there. Once again, you got to get that rebound if they miss. Got to come down and score quickly.
Got to block out.
Free throw is up. Oops, she got that one. That rattled. From this angle, it looked like it was starting to fade to the left.
Did.
If it was an 11-foot free throw instead of a 10-foot, she would have missed it. You could see it. It was just going, you know, 21 points. She hit them both. 60-51. Housley comes back out. Ball knocked away by Nicholson. Corbin's ball. Kylie Clem's going to trigger it in. Got to have some three-pointers right now.
Oh, yeah.
Or layups with fouls. Comes into Mahala Jordan. Mahala said that Emily Sizemore had her hands on her. Sizemore just laughs. At the free throw line, it'll be Darcy Anderson for Corbin. 60-51, North in the lead. Corbin led at halftime, but North owned the third quarter. Free throw is good. 23 points for the junior. Another big free throw here. Coach Wilson hopefully will come up and speak to us after this game. One more free throw coming to her. Got them both. 24 points. Kind of a free throw comes into Bella Sizemore. Bella almost lost it. Hangs on to it. Gives it off to big sis Emily. Emily Sizemore. Well, they try to get a foul call, but they don't get it. Give it back to Sizemore. 31 seconds. Going to do something. No, they're just going to let them dribble the ball.
Yes, they're just going to let them dribble.
And there's a foul called.
Should have done that about 20 seconds ago.
Yeah. Little late on that one.
Yep.
Kylie Clem picks up a foul. At the free throw line, with Emily Sizemore. Her free throw is good. 22 points, and she's gathered.
Yeah, I think I would have tried to foul a different
somebody
player.
Else. Should have found that young lady in the corner there. That she hadn't just gotten the game.
Yeah.
Or hadn't shot anything during the game. 62-53. Down the lane. Anderson shot no good. No foul called. She hits the deck. Back the other way. Sizemore has it. 11 seconds. Reagan Walker trying to steal it. They give it out to Nicholson. Reagan just going to walk off. That's the way it ends. North Laurel defeats Corbin by a final score of 62-53. We'll take a 2-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the final scoring of this game. You're listening to 2-minute timeout. You're listening to Corbin Lady Red Hounds on WCTT.
I hate box springs. Well, here at Sammy's Furniture,